Hello friend, welcome to Scala Deep Dive series powered by Nautilus Inc. I'm Divya Dua, working in Nautilus as software consultant. In the last session, we have discussed how the traits are just regular interfaces in the very basic form. Now, in this lesson, we are going to explore how we can provide method implementations in trait. Agendas for today's lesson will be using a trait like an abstract class, using abstract and concrete fields in traits. Now we will continue with our previous example of animal trait and modify it to see how trait behaves in different scenarios. So we have a trait animal that has two methods. One is speak, for which we are going to provide a default implementation. And there's another method walk, which we are going to leave as an abstract method. So our animal trait is defined. Now let's define a class dog that extends this animal trait. Since we are extending the animal trait in the class dog, so we need to provide the definition for method walk since it is abstract. If we do not provide the definition for the method walk, let's see what it says. It says the class dog needs to be an abstract since method walk in trait animal is not defined. So we'll be providing the method definition implementation for the walk method. So our dog class is defined. Now let's create an object for this class. Our object is defined. Now let's call the method speak with it. It gives us the default answer which we have defined here in the trait. And now when we call walk with this, it says let's go, which is defined here in the class. Now what if we want to give a different implementation to the method speak rather than using the default one? Let's do this in the class cat, which extends the same animal trait. Here we are again going to provide definition for method walk. And now we are going to provide a definition for method speak as well. Oops, this is given an error. What it says, let's see. Overriding method speak in trait animal. Method speak needs override modifier. Okay. So let's give this override modifier for the method speak. Okay, we are going to again define this class animal. To make the processing faster, let's use the copy and paste technique. And then we are going to use this override with this definition. And now our class cat is successfully defined. Okay, now let's create a object for this class. Our object is defined. Now let's call this walk method with it. It says let's go. And now we'll be calling a speak method with it. It gives hey, I'm kitty rather than I'm speaking, which is the default implementation. So you have seen how we can override the default implementation of methods and trait. So using a trait like an abstract class. So we can define the methods in our trait just like regular Scala methods, which we have seen with the speak method. In the class which extends the trait, you can override those methods or you can use them as they are defined in the trait. We have seen this scenario as well. If a class extends a trait without implementing its abstract methods, it must be defined abstract. Okay, this is what we the compiler has thrown an error when we are trying to define a class cat, class dog, without giving the implementation for the abstract method walk. A class can extend only one abstract class, but it can implement multiple traits. So using traits is more flexible. How we can implement multiple traits, this is what we are going to see in the next lesson. Now let's proceed further. So now we are going to see how we can define abstract and concrete fields in the trait. So suppose we have a trait pizza in which we have a field where number of toppings, and we are leaving it abstract, and then we have another field where size, for which we are going to provide a default value, and then we have another field val this time, which is max toppings, and for this also we are going to give an initial value. So our trait pizza is defined. Now let's use this trait in a class which is says suppose cheese pizza, which extends this pizza trait. And now since we are extending the trait in the class, so we need to define the values for the abstract fields, abstract field which is number of toppings. Otherwise we have to declare this class as an abstract class. So we'll be providing the value for this number of toppings field. So suppose it is now say 12. Okay, now what if we want to give a different value to the size variable? So we can simply do this by defining this. We don't need an override modifier, and also we don't need the var modifier. And see, our class cheese pizza is successfully defined. Okay, now let's define another trait, pizza trait, with a val max toppings, and this time we are leaving it as it. We are not defining any initial value. And now let's have a class say onion pizza, in which we are going to extend this trait pizza trait. And now let's provide the value for this val max toppings, suppose 10. So we have given it. Okay, now suppose we'll have another trait, now pizza trait 2. I am not getting another name right now. Now we have a val max toppings in which we are going to assign a value. Now let's use this pizza trait 2 in our class say capsicum pizza. Pizza trait 2. And now let's give the value to max toppings. We are using another value for it, say 12. It says reassignment to val. We were able to do this with when we have declared this variable as var, but when we have declared this variable as val and we have initialized the value, so again if we are trying to give another value to this max topping, so it is throwing an error. So now let's use the override with it. And we are giving it a value 12 again. And this time you can see we have successfully defined the class Capsicum Pizza. So using abstract and concrete fields and traits, define a field with an initial value to make it concrete, otherwise don't assign it an initial value to make it abstract. We have seen that we can define both abstract and concrete fields in our traits. In the class that extends the trait, you will need to define the values for the abstract fields, or otherwise we have to make the class an abstract. This is the case for both fields and for methods. If we don't provide the definition for the abstract methods or fields, so we have to declare the class as an abstract class. You don't need to use the override keyword to override a var field. Okay, this is what we have seen when we have assigned a value to a var field and we are trying to override this in another class. So we have simply given the name and the new value. But when we were trying to do the same with the val field, so we are required to use the override modifier. Otherwise, it throws an error that reassignment to val. So this is the things that we need to take care while defining the abstract and concrete fields in traits and using the trait in some class. Here are the references for this lesson. There's one blog on Noldus website, which is a story of traits part 2, and there are some other books like Scala cookbook, Scala in depth, which you can refer for learning more about traits. Thank you for watching, and for any queries you can mail me at divya.dua@noldus.in. Thank you.